What's going on, guys? It's your boy Adrian back again for another Alchemy Stars video. And for today, I will be presenting to you my top 7 best equipment for every 6-star Aurorians in the game. And yes, this is only for 6-star Aurorians. This does not include 5-star, 4-star, and 3-star Aurorians that I will list here. And the criteria that I choose when selecting the best 7 equipment for the 6-star units is that I did not account for the selfish buffs. I know selfish buff equipment is really strong, but my criteria for this one is it helps the whole team, not just for individual boost. So without further ado, let's get right into the list. So as of now, we have a total of 38 Aurorians, 6 stars. And I pick only 7 best equipment out of the 38 units here. So my number 7 spot goes to Uriel. So Uriel's equipment skill, Field of Ash, at Ascension 3, max level 10. At the start of each round, applies 1 stack of burn on enemies, occupying a red tile for 2 rounds. Each stack of burn increases Fire Aurorian's damage by 1.5%. Now, this is what I am talking about. This is not a selfish buff. This buff applies to every unit in your team. That is why I chose Uriel, even though it is kind of situational, because there are enemies who have immunities that you cannot debuff. But if you are fighting an enemy that can be debuffed, like burn for instance here, then this equipment skill is really strong and it's really helpful, especially for a mono fire team. That is why Uriel takes the 7th spot. Okay, next we have number 6, we have Luke, Shackled Soul. At Ascension 3, max level 10, active skills and chain combos inflict 1 stack of Parasitic Mark each time they deal damage. Parasitic Mark stacks up to 9 times. Each time an enemy moves 1 tile, each stack of Parasitic Mark deals 12% damage. This damage increases to 18% for the enemy with the highest number of stacks on the battlefield. Luke's normal attacks and chain combos deals 30% increased damage to the enemy afflicted with the highest number of Parasitic Marks. This is one of the best equipment skill in the game. This is not only a set buff because Luke can benefit from this one, but it helps your whole team because this one will give a debuff to the enemy, dealing some DOT damage. And I believe that this debuff is not, there's no immunity yet for this one. And this debuff is pretty good, especially in the arena matches, in the arena disc. Luke is pretty broken in that kind of game mode. And this one makes that happen. That is why this is on my top 7 list of best equipment in the game for the 6-star units. Okay, next we have on the 5th spot, we have Gronru. Gronru's Ionizer. At Ascension 3, max level 10, grants 1 magnetic storm per 3 rounds at the start of the battle. The next chain combo deals an additional 50% damage to 1 enemy within the area of attack and inflicts paralysis. Has a 50% chance to attack another enemy. Now, this one is on the list because of this debuff, paralysis. Paralysis is broken, guys. If the enemy can be paralyzed, you can fully utilize Gronru's paralysis there because paralysis really helps you stall in the game, especially if you are running a DOT team, a rainbow DOT team with OD, Pasalo, Nails, something like that. Paralysis is pretty helpful for stopping the boss attack and helping you to set up your tiles, which is why I chose Gronru in the top 5 slot. Next on the list, we have top 4. I have here Michael. So, Michael, ascension to Silent Thunder. Grants one stack of Silent Thunder mark at the start of each round. And when using an active skill or chain combo, normal attacks consume one stack of Silent Thunder mark to deal extra damage equal to 2.5% of current HP to the enemy. This one is pretty good, pretty powerful. One of the things that makes Michael so broken in the game, because of this HP cut, 2.5% of current HP to the enemy is no joke. Especially if you are dealing with high HP bosses. This one is pretty, pretty darn strong. And yes, if you have Michael, you should level her equipment to level 10. All of the units here in my list, you should level their equipment to level 10 because it is so damn worth it. Okay, next, top 3. We are now entering the top 3 and the third spot goes to Bethlehem. Bethlehem, Northern Power at Ascension 3, max level 10. Upon using an active skill or entering Aurora time, Bethlehem's basic attack is increased by 10% for this round. And other Water Aurorians will also gain an attack increase of 5% of Bethlehem's basic attack. This is a pretty, pretty powerful buff for your mono water team because 5% attack increase of Bethlehem's attack will is pretty darn good, especially if you level 80 your Bethlehem. This is no joke. That is why this one also, not only it benefits Bethlehem, it benefits the whole party or your whole team with this kind of buff. And that is why this is one of the best equipment in the top 3 spot. And yes, Bethlehem is really, really good. I don't have Bethlehem because I did not summon for her. But she will be back. She will be back in the first Annie. Okay, top 2 spot goes to Siobhan. Did I pronounce it correctly? Siobhan. I was told that it was that kind of pronunciation. Not Siobhan. Siobhan. So, Web Shield. At Breakthrough 6, max level, gains web mark. Clears all stack before taking damage and gains shield equal to 15% of Siobhan's depth for every stack cleared. If web mark stacks are more than 10, gains an additional shield equal to 15% of Siobhan's HP when gaining shield from web mark. This one is pretty, pretty good. One of the good things about Siobhan is giving the team a shield, and this shield is pretty good because it will not disappear unless you get attacked, and before you get attacked the shield will activate, so you will have a reduced damage, which is pretty good. This is some kind of a mitigation to my understanding on using Siobhan. This is type of mitigation, which is pretty good. You really don't need a healer when you have a lot of stacks. And this is pretty much very easy to achieve. With a lot of tile converters in the forest team, this one is pretty good, pretty darn strong. And what makes Siobhan a top tier unit? And lastly, the top number one spot goes to Sinsa. Killing Sun at Ascension 3, max level 10. Normal attacks can hit diagonally. Normal diagonal attacks, active skill, and chain combos afflict the target with one stack of shatter, which stacks up to 5 times. Each stack reduces the target's defense by an amount equal to 5% of Sinsa's basic defense for one round. This one is what makes Sinsa pretty broken. Sinsa is the only one that can do this one, the defense shredding debuff. And it scales up of Sinsa's defense, so you should raise Sinsa's defense by leveling him up to level 80 to fully utilize his kit. And this one is pretty darn strong. That is why Sinsa is so good, especially even in other mono element. You can use Sinsa as your captain because Sinsa as a captain is pretty darn strong because of this Defense Shredding debuff. So you should level 10 this one if you have Sinsa, and also raise Sinsa as much as you can. If you can max level him to 80, it is pretty much better to fully utilize this one. And yeah, this one is broken. This one is OP. And yeah, Sinsa is the top one with the best equipment in the game. And there you go. That is my list for the top 7 best equipment for 6-star Aurorians. I might do the best equipment for 5-star or 4-star probably later on, or maybe some other time. And anyways, that's it for me for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe. I would really appreciate it if you could help me grow my channel more. And thank you to everyone who are supporting my channel. I appreciate every one of you. Until next time, peace.